what we will do is this time is we'll make sure that we already have a register and login function wrote. So, but we do not create the JSON web token when we do the registration or login. So the first thing we should do is whenever user is doing registration or user is login, we want to return the user object as well as the token, JSON web token that we can create in the server that you want to return. So we'll see how to create the JSON web token and how to return in the response payload to the client. And then we'll also need to create another function. We can call it find me or revisit function. Is basically when you are refreshing your page, you want to call that function so that you check whether the user is already logged in or not. So you see already we have a register function which is calling insert, and then login is also just getting that user object is correct or not, or finding or not. So basically I'll create a new function which will be called as login, and the job of this function is to always get the token and put it into the response object. So that will be the job of this login function. So I'll create a new function here, which could be a function called as login, and this function will take the request and response. And this is basically a middleware kind of thing that we will put it in our existing route. So this is the middleware that will apply for all of our routes, right? So that it will do the validation. So what it should do is it should first get the user out of the request object. And once you receive the from the request.body, you get the user object, and then you want to get the token. So from how do you get the token? So you can go ahead and ask the auth controller to do that. When you log in, what we are doing is we are trying to create the new token and return. So that's the job. So auth controller, we have to import it. That we recently created auth controller, and we'll go to the controllers folder and get the auth controller module. So what we are trying to do is we're trying to create the JSON token. So we'll use auth controller and say generate token, right? And you need to pass the payload, which is basically user object. So take this user object, and then finally what you want to do is you want to return the response.json, and in the response.json we want to pass the user as well as token. This is what we want to do. Any question on this? So this is a small function which its job is to create a token and put it into the response object, right? And now I should call this function every time I do registration or every time I do login. So how to do this this two call function in Express.js is just like passing the next one. You remember the third parameter is the next parameter where you put more middleware, right? In our case, what is next is it is login. It's not the next. It's an actual function that you want to pass. So I want to call this login whenever this register is called, and if make sure that you are getting this next here. See, next is coming, but we are not calling it here, which is wrong. I should call this next function in the insert function. So I'll call here next. So this will call our login function, and it will make sure that in our response JSON we are returning it, right? So that is that thing. And then also when you register, when you log in, that time also you want to pass the login function, you want to call it, and here you should get this next and then call the next. One thing you should notice is when you are using middleware in Express.js, don't ever return the response. Okay, it should be returned only once, not twice. So I'm returning here once, and then in the login function I am returning one more time once. So you can just modify the response at one time only, right? And you see in the request I am saying I am getting the user object, but if you see in the insert function, request.body has a user, request.body has the user part, right? So if you see this user, I can just not return right now saved user from here. I have to wait till login is happening, right? So what should I do is I should just return not call this function response.json and just call next. So next will basically put the token and user object into that into that response object. So since this user is just having email ID or registration token, but we want the user which is coming from our database, right? We don't want to just return the user which is coming from the registration database. So if you see in this request.body, you have a user, but it is not yet saved in our database, right? This is the user which is coming from the request object. So while you call this next function, it is again taking the user from the body, which is again the registration user. So this is not helpful, because you want to sign the payload which has ID, and that ID should be our own database ID. So I think you should just wait till you save the data. So what I should do is, in this function, I'll first insert the data into our database and then get the data and put it into the request object. So I can always go ahead and put the request dot user is equal to this thing. And then I call the next, and where basically you go and then get the request dot user rather than body. You'll say request dot user. So this is the important thing. When you are writing your own middleware, you always modify the request object. You don't modify the response object. Response object is only modified once from the last middleware. Last pipeline. So in our case, this is the last pipeline, the next one. So next one will modify the response object. So this is very important to note. So I'll have to put the user in the request so that I pass to the next function by like this. You cannot pass the next one. You can pass some of the parameters here, but that's not a good idea. So good idea is to always modify the request object from each pipeline, and so that other middleware will get it from the request object. And finally, you modify the response. So see, here I am saying request.user, and get that user and get the token and put that token in the response. The same thing we will do in the get user by email ID and password. So here also you'll do the same thing. You'll get the you'll not modify the response dot this one, and we'll say request.user is equal to the saved user, and then you call the next function. So any question on this? Right. So what should we do is, after doing this, we should be fine basically. Now what I can do, I can just show you how, when we are calling register, I am getting the token. And next when we'll meet, what we'll do is we'll modify the client side code base. And in client side code base, what we should do, get this token, save it into the local storage, right? In the client side, we have to save it into local storage and then send it for every request that comes from the client side to the server, that JSON web token, by putting it into the header. So we'll see this in the later one, but let's finish this up in the server side. So let me check in this code form here. Added middleware to routes, let's say. So let me run this server side code base. So I can say npm run server at watch mode. It will run our server. Since we didn't do any client side code base, so I don't need to run client code. I just need to run the server. I'm just throwing exception. Required is not defined. So go, this is a typo mistake, right? Instead of require, I use required, and this is the file auth controller. So click control and then click goes to that file, and then remove this required thing. And since I am running my server in a watch mode, it should just crank up automatically. So it is restarting automatically, right? And see, our server is ready. It is watching. So let's go ahead and cross your fingers. And now what we should see is we should see that token is coming, right? What I'll do is this is my home page. I'll do F12. I'll go to the network, because in order to show what data is coming, we should go to the network for that. And here we should see, right? So when I go and log in, info at then in this request, I got error, right? So if you see the response, you received the error saying that expired in is not allowed. So it is coming from JSON web token. We use expired in, right? Expire in. So let me do one thing. Let me not expire in for now, just to for this demo. There is something going on. It is not happy with expiry. So I'll just remove this expiry for now. And let's continue. And now let's run the server in watch mode again. Okay, so we'll not put the expiry. Let it be undefined time, infinite time. It will never expire now by default. So login, right? It is 200, right? And my goal was to show you guys how JSON token comes, how it looks like. That is important thing, right? So go to the login callback, and then you should see the response. This is the response coming. I can take this object and open my Notepad++. Okay, I don't have that tool. So anyway, so now you see here, you have the user object. We pass two things, right? One is user object, and then another one is token. So this user is the part of that where we are passing the user object, which has everything. And next is the token. And this is the token which is coming from. So it has a dot, right? You remember I told you the style that it is. It is the first part dot, second part, and it will go till last, and this is the final dot, right? And if you remember that gist that we wrote, this main gist. No, this is the Heroku thing. This one. So here, if you go, you see the header, payload, and signature. Right? It has three things in the JWT: header dot claims dot signature. So header, and then claims, and then signature. So if I go here, this is my header. This is the claim. Claim means it has the actual user object inside this, basically encoded. And then finally is the signature, where you have the what kind of signature that it has created, right? And now you can take this token from here to here, and you can go to the jwt.io. If you go online, and then here you can try to debug. Encode and decode, right? So I think you can decode here. So if I put any token here, like our token which I got, remove the string part of it, and then if I say it is saying invalid signature, yeah, but it is saying invalid signature. That is important. So remember, you cannot just use it. No, it's not expired. You cannot use it because you do not know the secret key, but still you can see the data, right? So but this data is no use because you cannot use it anywhere, right? So don't put any secret part of it in the payload. Just put the data that you don't care, right? So and then it recognized that this is the algorithm which comes from the header metadata. I told you, right? The header will have the hashing algorithm, right? So you see the hashing algorithm it identified, and then payload is the actual data, and then finally is the signature, verify signature. And if you there is this invalid signature, you cannot use it. But the important thing you should note is whatever you put in your JWT, it can be used by anybody. Sorry, used means it can be read by anybody. They can read the payload, but they cannot use it and they cannot hack it, right? So any question on this? So you're good, right? What we did so far is we finished our server side, and this time we did new thing is we added our middleware, where we added the passport, right? And then in the passport, we had a two strategy. One is the login and one is JWT login. We just see right now the local login and JWT login, but we have not used any one of them for now, right? What we did is we use this one, local login now. I showed you, right? When you log in, it comes to local login strategy, and I can debug it and show it to you. But basically it is coming here, and then in the auth controller, it is getting and generating the token, right? And then finally, if you go to the route, so when you do login, it will call the middleware called as login. And here basically we are calling the generate token, and then using that user object, we are returning that token. Right, when we will do register and we'll see how, when we do the refresh, then we'll see how we are passing the token from the client, right? Next. So this token we have to store in the client side. Next, we'll see that part. So any question? Okay, let me check in this. Okay, so this concludes the server part of it. Next, we'll just focus on client side next. And I think after that, it will finish up. So once we finish the client side, we will see how we are doing login and refresh all of that. There won't be any server side changes pending, right? And after that, we'll do is we'll do some optimization of our code base. And next, we'll learn how to upload this code into cloud. And what I'll do is I'll take a separate session for Heroku in order to clarify what exactly Heroku is, how to do all of that. And we'll do a sample application in Heroku before we upload the Angular application. Because in Heroku, there are two different kind of things we have to do, right? We'll learn all of that next, that how to just vanilla Node.js project, how to upload. And then we'll see actual our project, what are the needful changes we have to do in order to upload in Heroku. And we'll do live debugging, live coding, live logging, check the log, build and scale your application, all of that. And after that, mostly our project will be completed. So this project is like full stack from till deploying up to the cloud. And then we'll see after that. Then we'll go to the NGRX. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.